look through my lens and you're gonna see what I'm talking about.
Oh, praise the Lord. Rababa, rigabo, rababa.
Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Welcome back to another vlog. If this is your first time, you're welcome to the family. My name is Jenna Chinwo and I'm a Nigerian YouTuber based in Port Harcourt. So you guys, this morning we're going to the gym. If you guys have noticed, I've been bloating and adding up. Well, necessarily, I don't know why, but I don't want to be looking like a mama yabo inside my wedding dress. I cannot come and keep myself. I don't want to look like that. So I am doing the one I can do so that I will look like a baby girl that I am. So this is what I'm wearing to the gym. I go to the gym like every day. Yes, for the past couple of weeks now, I've been going to the gym every day. And then after that, I'm going for my marriage class today. I've not taken you guys on any of the section, so I'm going to be taking you guys on my marriage class today. Me and Hubby are going for marriage class. And then after that, we'll be going getting gun hunting. But any which way, guys, if this is your first time, you're welcome to the family. And if you're a returning subscriber, thank you so much for coming. So let's dive right into this video.
Mama told me, but if I lay down and I play dead and I stay dead, maybe you'll get sick of being the monster out of my head, under my bed. Think you're something out of my nightmares. See me right there. But if I lay down and I play dead and I stay dead, then will you get bored of killing me?
Silhouettes of you are like a taunt. Never really know just what you want. With you I don't ever feel calm. I can feel the sweat inside my palms. Play with me like cats and a string. You don't understand the pain it brings. You don't ever wanna give me wings. You don't ever wanna set me free. You know I'm addicted to you. And it's twisted, you've been gifted with the evil voodoo. Got me coming back for more, even when I've been screwed. Dolls full of pins, pierce my heart straight through. Got issues in my head. I like you in my bed, but you keep me on red. Oh, everything is like a test. I better not text or I'll come off desperate.
But if I lay down and I play dead and I... We are officially going for the marriage class. Yeah, I came back from the gym and now I'm set to go for the marriage class. I don't know why my hair is entering my mouth. I have my Bible, everything here, and I have water. Since I'm going to the gym, I've been taking a lot of water. So you guys, I'm coming with me. Let's go to church, and after church we're gonna talk, okay? Why? Hey guys, so we are back from the marriage class officially. We've been there for like, God, Jesus, that class, they like almost 4 hours class. Like, I legit slept small. But right now, I'm going back home. So we've done today's one, so we're not doing it again till like next week, because we do twice in a week. Tomorrow I'm traveling.
You didn't tell him.
I know we didn't plan. The Wednesday he was talking was last week. It was next week.
This week, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday.
No.
He will do, I mean, you know. That's why he said this remaining 2 days, he needs to finish this week and then plan for the court guy.
If he says Wednesday, we don't have what he will teach us that Wednesday because we're almost done with everything. But we'll still call him now. Because tomorrow is the main clearance with that man. Then this like this hunger, they cash me. I'm a queen, I'm a beauty, I'm beautiful. Are you saying how beautiful I am? Look through my lens. Look through my lens and you're gonna see what I'm talking about. Hey guys, so I'm on my way going home. After the class, Uncle went back to work, so we just have to like go back to our normal activities. Right now I'm going back home. And I'm very, very hungry. I'm looking for food. Like, when I mean hungry, I am very, very hungry. Sitting down for like 3 hours class, not be going chop. But when I get home, I'm going to talk to you guys and tell you guys how the class went and all of that. For now, I want to eat, because if you're listening to me, you notice I don't even have the energy to talk very well. I'm dehydrated. I'm starving. Everything is wrong with me right now. So once I get home, I'll talk to you guys, okay? Guys, meet my boy Jeremiah. He said I should put him on YouTube.
He won't put me, you know, how to do it. We'll collect the money, we'll go chop and nothing they happen. Kilo Shelle.
Wait, you be worried about you be Yoruba?
Anything, you know, we did the streets. We did the way we did one.
Anyhow, you did also. Also.
You know, anyhow, when you come, go share and you know how to do it. You're really smart in it.
Legit also.
You go your war, cash out.
So, guys, I'm finally going to Chicken Republic because that's the only place I know I can get food that is sweet and I won't spend much. So I'm going to Chicken Republic to get food.
She go buy for me. I go chop.
Let me tell you something. He was asking me when I was talking. He was asking me, who am I talking to? That there's nobody here. Nah, you know they follow me. They talk. Who are you talking to? But there's nobody.
We
here.
Talk to each other. You know nobody talk on the street. That's so. We talk to each other.
We talk to each other.
Easy. So that seed is also that will
pray. So that seed is
also
fast.
You know, give testimony for church.
Why you want
to
give testimony?
I don't want to be easy. You know, I
shop
something like this last.
Now, so. You know, they wash person, I beg.
See? That be smart, you know. I go shop where I call fat, where we're joining.
Guys, this man is very, very, very funny. I swear
to God. She go pay me. This is going to be bribing, you know. Yeah. Pastor, they didn't collect, so on a pastor and money that they collect.
You be pastor?
I want for you. And I'm going to the cabbage.
That your rabba and a cabbage for you, cabbage.
Yeah, how many pastors they speak this over that they cash out?
Hey guys, so I'm back from church and I'm just sitting outside and I said let me just talk to you guys real quick on how it went down, how the church went down and everything. Guys, my boatman was just, the man is just too funny. I was laughing all through till I got home. So you guys, one thing I've never told you guys and I'm saying it right here because I think it's something that actually should be in your mind if you're getting married. I know I'm just getting married, but then having a court wedding is important. I don't know if I should say important, but importanter, because the wedding is important, but the court wedding is importanter. Very, very important. And also the church you're getting married at is also important. You should know the church you're getting married. Is it the one that you know is already, how do I put it, is recognized by federal government that, okay, you know you're getting married, is registered in court? Or is the one that you have to go to court to register? If it's the one that you have to go to court to register, then trust me, you have to do it. You definitely have to do it. Because why I'm saying this is because I was watching a video of a lady. She was getting married and then she didn't go to court. She didn't do a court marriage. And unfortunately for her, when she lost her husband, nobody is praying for anybody to lose anybody. I'm just giving instances. When she lost her husband, the husband's brother came to collect the husband's property from her. In as much as she had 5 children, she had 3 boys and 2 girls. And she was like, you cannot take property, my husband's property. I have children that will inherit it. And the man was like, you're not married to him, that you guys were just living together. These people did white wedding, they did traditional marriage, they did every marriage right, and they're like, you're not married to him, so we can take the property. And the lady was like, you're not serious, that she went to church, she wed her husband in so church. The man said, okay, they should go to court. And unfortunately, guys, this marriage was not registered in court. And I think this is one thing that we, a lot of Nigerians, we don't really look at, or we don't really pay attention to. We just feel it's the church, it's all about the church. But you forget that you also have to register it in court. It has to be recognized. Even if it's to do a separate court marriage, then do it. So what I'm saying this is because filling up my marriage process and all of that, and I was being told this, and also seeing the movie as well, it made me to like, it's like an eye-opener that, okay, if you have an advice to people out there, it's more like do a court marriage no matter what it takes. Trust me, you want to do that court marriage. That court marriage is very, very important, because when I was asking a friend of mine that is a lawyer, he was like, obviously it's not recognized anywhere. Anybody can go to one bachelor church and get married, and it's not registered in court. It is not recognizable. Anybody can come any day and tell you that you guys were just living together, because it's, even if she paid your traditional rights, even if the husband should say he's no longer interested, you guys are no longer together, or she leave you and go marry someone else, he has every right to his property unless he chooses to give you or your children any of the property. You can, the husband can still do that. But when you do it in court and he knows that, oh, whatever he's doing, court is involved, you bring your lawyer, he brings his lawyer, you guys will judge it out, you give your children his inheritance because you guys have agreed and you guys have registered it, and the state or the federal government is aware of it. It is registered there that you guys are doing court marriage. Then it's very important. So guys, before we started our marriage class, we had to go to court. We had to do the court marriage registration first. That was the first thing the church told us, because it's registered there that you guys are having a court marriage. And if it's a situation whereby your church, as long as you're getting married, they will tell you to register in court, and the court will send you a certificate. That's your marriage certificate to the church. Then that's safer for you, because some churches are already linked to what do they call it, to court, like the Anglican church, the Catholic church, I know those two, and Methodists, all these other churches, they are linked to court already. So you have to go to court. You know, some Pentecostal churches, they are not linked to court, so some of them will tell you, some of them, see, majority of them might not even tell you to go and register in court. They just read you guys there. Why some will tell you that you should register in court. Now, if with or without them telling you, just know that you still have to register in court. And you guys, my marriage class has been going on so well so far, and so good so far. I've been learning a lot. I've been not just learning, I've been understanding some basic things, which I don't know how to say this, because I just feel that by God's grace we'll cross that bridge, okay? But you guys, that's it for this video. I just said let me talk to you guys, because this part was very, very important about registering your marriage in court and all of that. I hope you enjoy watching this video. Thank you so much guys for watching. I will see you in my next video. Bye.